barren, dangerous, inhospitable. These are words that are often used to describe the Arctic. Yet, the Inuit have lived there for thousands of years. They have an intimate connection with the land. It's kui majitukanji, or IQ, which means that which has been long known. It's not our concept of the Arctic. This research takes us to King William Island to Joe Haven, where elders express concern that the practice of using government and caribou co-management board data to map herds is insufficient. Their maps indicate there's no caribou in their region. It's important to understand the significance of caribou. They are vital to the culture, social, and health of Inuit communities. So in a series of workshops, 31 elders reluctantly drew their caribou knowledge on maps using Mylar and markers. And their hesitance comes from their understanding that the world is constantly changing. A caribou never walks in the same steps year after year. So a line drawn on a map saying here really means here. So these maps were recreated in digital duplicates to use in a Geographic Information System, and a fuzzy data approach was used. This is where a 20-kilometer buffer was added to those lines that were drawn here, and that's to compensate for that here aspect of the data. And that 20 kilometers was selected because the terrain is extremely flat, and 20 kilometers is a reasonable distance to be able to observe a caribou herd. When these maps are layered one on top of the other, they create this collective caribou knowledge surface. And these red hotspots, they're hotspots of caribou knowledge. That's where 75% of the elders drew caribou routes. So what makes this research unique is I haven't used Western data in conjunction with IQ. I have used Kawi Mojitukanji to highlight the deficiencies in the status quo. IQ is science, and omitting it from data is culturally unacceptable. There are thousands of years of knowledge and that Inuit intimate connection to the land that will help us better understand the changes that are occurring in our Arctic today. Kuyunamiak, thank you.